forgotten that once we were brought here, we were robbed of our name, robbed of our language. We lost our religion, our culture, our God. And many of us, by the way we act, we even lost our mind.
Here it is, bam, and you say, God damn, this is a dope jam. But let's define the term called dope, and you're thinking me funky now, no. Here is a true tale, by the ones that deal, all the ones that fail, yeah. You can move if you want to move. What it prove? It's here like the groove. The problem is this. We gotta fix it. Check out the justice and how they run it. Selling, smelling, sniffing, riffing. And brothers trying to get swift in. Selling their own, rob a home. While some shrivel a bone like comatose walking around. Please don't confuse this with the sound. I'm talking about
bass.
Bass. Come on.
Yes, yes, yes. It is Thursday, September 20th. I may seem a little bouncy. Things, I've been working on the sciatic nerve injury here. So I'm sitting on my ball, trying to relax my back. Welcome to the Thursday edition. No, it's Tuesday. See, I'm all discombobulated. This is the Tuesday in the news segment, but hopefully you'll join us on Saturday or Thursday for the show. We're going to try to do the settlement this week. I'm testing out a new angle so you can see more now. Like I said, we're going to keep testing and playing around with stuff until we get it the way we want to, and the lighting and everything the way we want to. So this is in the news segment, as I said, and we're just going to get right into it. First, let's start off with what's happening in the news. In case you missed it, Nick Gordon found legally responsible in the Bobby Christina Brown's death. I guess this allows him to go forward in the civil case. He doesn't have any money, so, you know, that's like beating a dead horse. He does seem really suspect in this case, and, you know, from what I heard, what I saw, you know, they all were getting high. I think he was beating on the girl, and I think they were all into drugs, and something went wrong. In other news, we have the, I'm sure a lot of people have been following this, the Wells Fargo case. And you know, this is the amazing part to me, when we're fighting all the time to get ahead here in America, and every time you turn around, there's some white man stealing $100 million, $200 million, doing all types of unscrupulous things, and then acting like we got a problem. So, I mean, they didn't pay this man close to $200 million just to walk away from the position. I guess he's sitting in front of Congress trying to tell what happened. They were creating bogus accounts and giving those people that created those bogus accounts, giving them bonuses and creating credit card accounts without customers' consent. So isn't that fraud and theft? It's amazing. The banks were part of the cause of the whole housing collapse, and now here we are again. And this may be just the first one that's getting caught. They should lock his ass up, but they're not. He's got his $200 million, and he's going to keep it moving, and it's a damn shame. Unbelievable. We're going to stop over in Chicago. We've been keeping account. This account is not right because it does not include murders from yesterday. I think we're at about 526 here in Chicago, with 3.5 months still to go. So look for that 600 to hit us right before the New Year's. There was also something, and this happened, I didn't find out this happened like a few days ago, actually on September the 16th is when this shooting happened with Terrence Crutcher. And I'm sure a lot of people saw the video. And I don't know, should I play it for you? I'll go ahead and play it for you. Hopefully this sound comes through without a problem. I'll see you in a second.
This guy's still walking. Following commands.
Time for taser, I think.
That's a gun. I got a feeling that's about to happen.
That looks like a bad dude, too. To be on something.
Which way are they facing?
For you.
Please, one.
But, most people have probably seen this video about 10 to 20 times.
They're facing westbound.
They got different
angles. I
think
he may have just been tasered.
But we know how the story is going to go. Rumors are spreading that he had PCP in the system or PCP in the truck. I just don't get how you got four or five officers and one dude without a weapon. And nobody thinks that four or five dudes and a woman can't take down this one dude. You all got tasers.
The first caller
hit him with the tasers
informed that a man
and take him out that way. It's I guess it's real difficult to take out a black man. Maybe I'm just too used to seeing incidents in the hood with four or five people able to take down one big dude. I don't know. It just seems crazy that every time it comes to showing the right constraints with black people, it's got to be escalated from, they used to take out a baton or tase you, they go straight to killing with black people. Now she's a cop, her husband's a cop, you know, everybody's going to talk about how great she is, and then they're going to bring up this guy's criminal record. Like it justifies something. So he had a criminal past. Doesn't mean he was doing anything criminal right then and there. But this is their MO. They're gonna always paint us with that broad brush of this is why we stopped them. Or then they didn't stop him. The man's car had broke down. So it's not like there was any danger, and if you watch the video, you don't see any danger. There was no gun on him or inside the vehicle. And I said, if there were drugs found inside the vehicle, why didn't the chief say something at that time? He said a thing about the gun. I'm sure if there was some drugs in there, maybe he would have said that too. But it doesn't seem like he's trying to cover up. You know, we'll wait to see, nothing as usual. And last but not least, people are upset about Obama's speech at the Black Caucus. And, you know, some people took it as an insult. And it's shocking, these same people don't take nothing that Donald Trump says as an insult. But anything Hillary says or anything Barack says is an insult. Let me see. I don't know if you all seen this about him talking about his legacy. I'll try to play this for you, see what we get.
So if I hear anybody saying their vote does not matter, then it doesn't matter who we elect. Read up on your history. It matters. We've got to get people to vote. In fact, if you want to give Michelle and me a good send-off, and that was a beautiful video, but don't just watch us walk off into the sunset now. Get people registered to vote. If you care about our legacy, realize everything we stand for. for is at stake. All the progress we've made is at stake in this election. My name may not be on the ballot, but our progress is on the ballot. Tolerance is on the ballot. Democracy is on the ballot. Justice is on the ballot. Good schools are on the ballot. Ending mass incarceration, that's on the ballot right now. And there is one candidate who will advance those things. And there is another candidate whose defining principle, the central theme of his candidacy, is opposition to all that we've done. There's no such thing as a vote that doesn't matter. It all matters. And after we have achieved historic turnout in 2008 and 2012, especially in the African American community, I will consider it a personal insult, an insult to my legacy, if this community lets down its guard and fails to activate itself in this election. You want to give me a good send-off? Go vote! And I'm going to be...
I'm totally offended. I don't understand how anyone can be offended by that, but then again, I'm not a Republican. My agenda isn't to ruin the country. My agenda is not to blame the other party for my failures. And my agenda is not to gain power by any means necessary. You see all the commercials on TV. A ton of Republicans, they hate that they even have to socialize with Donald Trump. Because remember, he's not their candidate. But he's the one that's got the opportunity to win. So some of them are going to stand there and suck up. I expected more out of Obama's presidency, like a lot of us did. But we got what we got, and what did we ask for? That's the first question. We didn't ask for anything. We just were happy to have the black president. And I'm not sure how much he could have did anyway, because they were fighting that battle of getting the country back on his pedestal. And that's why it's so important to win the office right now, because remember, when you go into a new president's term, the first 2 years are still extenuating policies from the previous. We already see the numbers. We already see the economy turned around and everything. But the Republicans will tell you the country's being destroyed. They'll tell you that the Affordable Care Act is destroying the system. We can see from Wells Fargo, the system is already destroyed. I don't care about you guys making a couple of extra $1 million if everybody gets health care. It balances out. Hopefully everybody can join on Thursday. We're going to talk about the settlement, which is going to be a show about the killings of the young and old blacks and money given to the families. And is the money worth anything, or would you rather see those people in a jail cell? So we'll catch you on Thursday. Love, peace. So we out of here.